Hello everyone. This channel provides the latest information on the Three Gorges Dam. If you are interested, please subscribe to our channel. Everyone loves the Three Gorges Dam. At 8 a.m. local time in China on August 2nd, the water level of the Three Gorges Dam was 159.27 meters. Compared to the 28th of last month, the water level has risen nearly 5 meters. Looking at this dam from the reservoir side, the water level is around here. At 8 a.m., the discharge of the Three Gorges Dam is 17,600 cubic meters per second. The maximum discharge of hydroelectric power from this dam is about 31,000 cubic meters per second, so it is estimated that the power generation situation is about 57%. Around 18 power generation turbines are in operation. According to data from the Hunan Provincial Watergate Administration, changes in the inflow and outflow of the Three Gorges Dam this month are as follows. The black line is the outflow, the green is the inflow, and the blue is the dam level. As you can see, since the middle of last month, they have set the upper and lower limits of release to a certain amount, and have been operating in a different pattern. On July 27, the inflow to the Three Gorges Dam surged due to flooding upstream. Despite this, there was no change in dam operation and the reservoir level rose. This means that the dam's original flood control function has been demonstrated. Since then, the inflow to the dam has decreased and is similar to the situation at the beginning of last month. So they may do the same operation as back then. The water level today was 149.17 meters last year, so this year it is 10 meters higher.
NISHIYAN Channel.
By the way, did you know that floods are occurring in various parts of China now? On the 27th of last month, flooding occurred in Sichuan province, upstream of the Three Gorges Dam. As I told you, the water level of the dam rose sharply because of this. 2 days later, a typhoon made landfall in Fujian, China. Heavy rain and strong winds have caused extensive damage. After making landfall, the typhoon turned into a tropical depression, but it still moved northward without weakening. In Anhui province, which is located downstream of the Three Gorges Dam, the water level rose and floods occurred. In addition, the tropical depression moved north and reached Beijing. It was so bad that the highest level of heavy rain warning was issued for the first time in 12 years, and there are reports of bridges collapsing and cars being washed away into the river. Floods are now raging all over China, forcing people to evacuate. In the long run, what will the situation be like when you see this dam? This is macro-micro data, a graph of water levels going back to 2015. You can see that the water level was the same every year. However, the data is clearly different from last year to this year. Plotting the past high water levels during the flood period, except for 2020 when the weather was abnormal, it looks like this. This year, it surpasses past numbers. Even though it hasn't been raining that much, the water level is already high because of this situation. The dam has important roles: flood control, power generation, and navigation of ships. On the other hand, it is also true that there are many problems such as sand accumulation, environmental destruction, climate change, cracks, and garbage problems. They choose the best water level in terms of hydropower, ship operation, and irrigation water, and insist that it is always safe. Is it true? The annual monthly precipitation around the Three Gorges Dam is as follows. August has started. Statistically, the amount of rain will gradually decrease. As far as this channel investigated, the area covered by the Three Gorges Dam seems to be around the red frame. Let's take a look at Windy's predictions for the week ahead. Weak rain clouds will spread around and upstream of the Three Gorges Dam, but will not have a significant impact. A typhoon is approaching from the east and will reach near Shanghai. However, Windy predicts that it will change course and turn back east. There are many typhoons passing through China this year, and it may be the effect of abnormal weather. In addition to this channel, I also run a YouTube channel that introduces Japanese dams. The channel has already surpassed 900 subscribers, sharing the charm of sophisticated and beautiful dams. The URL is listed in the summary column, so if you are interested, please check it out. the crane is ridiculously large. In this photo, the red structure on top of the dam. I think this is a crane, but do you know how big it is? It's not very noticeable when viewed from a distance, but it seems to be quite big when viewed from a close distance. You can see the car at the foot of the crane. The height of a passenger car is about 1.5 meters, so if you count it visually, it seems to be about 16 cars high. Is it about 24 meters? A typical condominium is about 3 meters per floor, so it seems to be equivalent to an 8-story condominium. This giant crane rides on rails and moves the dam from side to side. As you may know, there are not many earthquakes around the Three Gorges Dam. It is possible that this was also taken into consideration when constructing the dam. But upstream of the dam, and tributaries of the Yangtze River, it's a different story. In particular, Sichuan Province is an earthquake-prone area, and in 2008 the Sichuan Great Earthquake occurred. Nearly 70,000 people were killed and about 20,000 people were missing. Earthquakes can cause landslides and create dammed lakes. If it collapses all at once, secondary disasters will occur in downstream areas. In addition, many huge dams have already been built on the steep land upstream. They are located near earthquake-prone zones. Don't just focus on the Three Gorges Dam. We should also look upstream. Based on these things, I also tell you the latest earthquake information. This is a video that summarizes information about the Three Gorges Dam, and is a popular video that has been viewed more than 150,000 times. The URL is posted in the summary column, so please enjoy it. The rainy season has come to an end. It will rain more from now on. In 2020, heavy rains and floods continued, and there was concern that the dam might collapse. Conversely, there was a drought last year, and the water shortage continues this year as well. This year, the Chinese meteorological authorities have already announced the possibility of extreme weather and high temperatures. Please continue to subscribe to our channel for the latest information.